Good morning, student. This is my third session. In this session, we will learn about types of membrane and their permeability. Let us recapitulate the points we have studied in the previous session. In the previous session, we have learned about the introduction, the discovery and history of the cell, unicellular and multicellular organisms, shape, size and number of cells, prokaryotic cell, eukaryotic cell, detailed structures of prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. Now, the basic components also we have discussed about. Basic components, that is the plasma membrane or the cell membrane, cytoplasm and the nucleus. Now, in this session, we will study about the membranes or types of membranes on the basis of their permeability. Before discussing this types of membrane on the basis of their permeability, we will discuss few important points. The first point is the solvent and the solute. What is solvent? Solvent is a liquid. Solvent is a liquid that can dissolve another substance. And solute is the substance that can dissolve in the liquid. What it means? Solvent is a liquid in which solute can be dissolved. Now, for example, let us take the solution of sugar in water. Sugar is what? Sugar is solute and water will be the solvent. So solute and solvent point is clear. Now let us discuss about the kind of permeability. First point that we are going to discuss is the impermeable. What will be the impermeable? If a membrane does not allow solvent or and solute molecules to pass through it, it is called as impermeable membrane. It is called as impermeable membrane, means nothing to be get inside or nothing to be come outside from the membrane. So no entry and exit is allowed. Example, cuticle layer, where we usually a thin layer, waxy thin layer is there. That is the example of impermeable membrane. Now next topic is that permeable. Permeable means permeable membrane. Permeable, if a membrane allows both solvent and solute molecules to pass through it freely, then the membrane is called as permeable membrane. Example, primary cell wall. Now in class 8 we have discussed about the cell wall. Where the cell wall is present? Cell wall is basically present in the plant cell, and it has three. Cell wall is categorized into three parts: the primary cell wall, the secondary cell wall, the tertiary cell wall. So the primary cell wall is permeable in nature, means the entry of solute and solvents are allowed, entry also and exit also, and all type of molecules can enter inside it. Now next topic is semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane means if a membrane allows only the passage of solvent molecules but not the solute particles, then this type of membrane is called as semi-permeable membrane. And whatever the artificial membranes that we used to have, that is the example of semi-permeable membrane. Especially for the separation, we used to have the semi-permeable membrane in which the solute used to be filtered there and solvent used to pass out. Fourth is selective permeable. Selective permeable, if a membrane allows the passage of solvent and only few selected solutes, this is called as the selective permeable membrane, and that example is plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is considered as a selective permeable membrane because only the selected solutes are allowed for the entry or the exit through this membrane. Now let us discuss about the plasma membrane. It is also called as the cell membrane. Plasma membrane or the cell membrane.